And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, man. I love Mondays because I get to see my friend Dan Soder across the table from me, everyone.
Yeah, but I saw you on Friday.
Mm-hmm. But I like Mondays because we get to go do radio together for the first time in several days.
Oh, I didn't get it at first.
We get to play together on the radio.
Goddamn right we do.
I can't say to you, do you want to come over and play anymore? It seems like a weird thing to ask you.
Or does it?
Well, everyone, it's The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. That cough.
Oh, I thought you were doing that as a sarcastic cough. Where you go, it's Sirius XM 95.
And then I dabbed.
Whoa.
I dabbed it out.
Modern J?
Modern J. I'm getting down with the new stuff. Well, you know, I was standing only a few feet from Lil Uzi Vert this weekend, so I'm...
Where?
Where did you
see Uzi Vert? Where did you see Lil Uzi Vert?
I went down on Saturday, made a gut call. I saw the Sixers win their last regular season game by... They were winning the whole game by about 30-some points.
Yeah, it was an ass-whooping. That was the same night the Nuggets lost to the Timberwolves.
It was.
So I'm not mad about it.
No, you're not bitter at all.
It's a good day. I'm so happy they won their last regular season.
Well, I'll tell you what was interesting.
No, because it's just like really cool that you know you guys are already
smashing your face a bit. In fairness, the Milwaukee Bucks needed that game, so it wasn't that they were playing a team that was ready to get rolled over.
Yeah,
and the Sixers annihilated them. So after that, I made a gut call, impulse buy. That night you were able to buy playoff tickets.
So
no announcement of the day yet.
So they didn't tell you when it was going to be. They just said you can buy playoff tickets.
The ticket said Sunday to be determined, like time to be determined.
Okay.
But I bought them, and then the next morning,
the
schedule comes out, and it's Saturday night.
Perfect.
So I got to jockey around work now to make this happen, but I wanted to make it happen, and everyone was cool. Shout out, much love to Patrick Milligan at the stand, and SD from the cellar, who both were understanding, let me out of my obligations to do these shows to go down to the game. And man, I've never been to a playoff game in my life, ever. Have you been to one before?
I've been to
of any sport.
Yeah, I went to Bronco playoff games because my uncle had season tickets and he didn't have anybody to go with, so I would just go even though I was a 49ers fan.
That's some sad shit.
Yeah. I mean, we don't talk anymore, but he had season tickets and no kids, and his wife sucked.
Jesus. So he wanted she to didn't go. Want to go, so he wanted somebody to go with. That's pretty cool. Way to scoop up a free ticket to a game.
I
mean,
I got to watch like 10-year my. People are amazed I'm not a Broncos fan. It's like I was just loyal to the Niners.
But you just went to the game and check out a football game. You're a football fan.
Yeah, I love football, and I got to watch John Elway. I mean, he was like, you know, a legendary quarterback. I got to watch a lot of fun teams. Like I saw Bronco teams from the Dan Reeves era, Wade Phillips, into Mike Shanahan, and I liked the Broncos when they got Mike Shanahan because he was the offensive coordinator of the 49ers.
Shanahan.
My friend Carrie growing up, she would get so drunk that her eyes would get wonky, and I'd call him Shanahan eyes. I said she looked like Mike Shanahan when she got hammered. She didn't take that compliment too well. It wasn't a compliment either.
Did her eyes go screwy when she got hammered?
Oh yeah.
That's weird. That was a tell on Christine too. It was always weird.
Wonky eyes.
I mean, it actually does a different thing than normal. Like her left eye.
Bring up Mike Shanahan's face to show the kind of eyes.
Her left eye started taking a float over to the left. It would go crazy.
Dude, her eyes would get like all weird and pinball-y. But
I want to say this, but I don't want people to think we're ignoring this so that we forgot, because I already see the phone lines are lighting up. As we told you to call in, we are going to, after the first commercial break, we are going to be getting to the system talk, because I already see... we already have Jesse from Indiana and Tyler from Michigan on the line, ready to just lay down the specs.
Dude, I can't wait to hear specs from systems, but that's going to be after our first commercial break.
Yeah, so hang on the line, guys, or you know, call back, whatever you want to do. But it's just to let you know. So
you've been, that was your first. So I went to Broncos playoff games. I got to go to like some cool playoff games.
Never basketball.
Never went to a Nuggets.
Oh wait, no, didn't game. You go to? You went to one of the games of the Cavs.
Oh, shit. I went to a finals game. Yeah.
Cavs Warriors.
I went to Cavs Warriors game 6.
That's crazy.
I just remember that. Yeah. That was. I got a ticket when I was working Hilarities, where Jay will be April 23rd through the 26th. God, I hope that's right.
Mm-hmm. April 26th.
Close. Jay's going to be in Cleveland April 26th through April 28th. Or April 26th through April 28th. Yeah. So I was at Hilarities when Cleveland was in the finals, and I got to go to game six. And that was crazy. That was unbelievable. That was like the big SWAT, and they won to push it to seven.
So that's why I felt that awesome excitement. To go to
but this
one
is your team.
It's my team.
This would be like if I got to go to a 49er playoff game.
It's my team.
It would mean a lot.
That has been in the dark as far as like basketball goes for several years now.
Yeah.
And this year, I think we're only expected to do well. You know, like okay, maybe a low seeding in the playoffs. You know, mm-hmm. everyone said like maybe they can eke into that eighth spot. They finished third.
Yeah.
In the East. Below two teams that were just like their records were so far and above beyond, but we beat everybody else in the Eastern Conference on record, which is amazing with these two kids. And I was so hilariously emotional when I went to this game. I was more than I possibly thought I was going to be. They had the hype video, the Welcome to the Moment hype video. Yeah. Christine, do you have that at all? Because I think they talk during it enough that it's an audio. And I just fell right for the NBA films, you know, like we work hard together to do. And I have no affiliation to playing team sports other than the pickup basketball always.
Sure.
But you play pickup basketball. You were playing against a guy one game that you were playing with the last time. But I don't know why I buy right into them. I'm like, these 12 guys
are special.
Band together. Because together, these guys, there's undrafted guys in there. And there's guys in there who left the team and came back to the team.
It's just funny.
Oh, God. Ben Simmons had to work through a full year of injury.
That's just like the thing that you can get behind and become corny for. You know what I'm saying? Like, we can make fun of Jacob for liking sharks, but like he gets hyped.
Can you though?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We could tee off.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. You're a fish nerd. I mean, we could.
Bacon's feeling good because he baked a cake and everyone's loving it.
Yeah, bake up.
So you see Bacon starts chubbing up.
Yeah, and he's dressed all fucking post-apocalyptic cool-like. Sheepskin.
I got my sheepskin hoodie on.
Yeah, Bacon's got some power game to him. But what I was saying is, it's great. Oh, here it is. Is this it?
Said that R. Kelly had
this is
double audio.
I'm not sure.
Double audio.
I'm not sure if this is the video, but it has an official logo on it, so it might be the actual hype video they use. But there's quite a few that have been made.
Hell yeah.
The entire time I knew him, he only ever had one goal: to wipe out half the universe.
Wait, what?
If he gets all the Infinity Stones, he can do it with the snap of his fingers.
This is a joke.
That's a joke. That's hilarious. That is so funny that they just put Avengers to the playoffs. Or I was like, hold on.
Do like in-house hype video.
Yeah. Your Sixers are the Avengers?
Run it.
40 games, even in the miserable East. Greg Oden was also hurt in college, so was Joel Embiid. He is now Greg Oden.
We are talking about the next LeBron James, the next it player in the NBA. Yeah, he's definitely overrated because I keep watching and waiting and watching and waiting.
Skip Bayless,
this
I
young
hate
man
you.
Just befuddles me more and more. I don't see the motor. I don't see the intensity. I don't see the passion.
And the piano. Tell us when you start getting welled up.
Take over.
Oh man! I don't think this is even the exact video from the thing. This is just a great one. I'm just excited to watch
just
it.
Watching him.
Oh yeah. Sorry, I got wrapped up. Well, I mean, the dog. This is like they just have a Skip. What's his name? The Skip Bayless or whatever, just shitting on Ben Simmons. The thing we saw was just like this awesome.
But this is a little taste of what it's like.
This kind of music.
Like,
Yeah. And then the whole thing. Welcome. First of all, the fucking marketing genius. The marketing genius behind calling this like you have to wait for the process.
Mm-hmm.
Trust the process. And then they keep doing trust the process. And now their thing is like welcome to the moment.
Is this it?
This is the same video. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It's the welcome to the moment. Thing. If you do in-house hype video,
it's fine. We don't have to find it.
But it's it's just so yeah. When they were doing all that, and you show them like the guys like, diving out of bounds to get balls, all slow mo, and breathing heavy on the sidelines.
Yeah, that's why marketing people are geniuses. Like, they know how to get you fucking. They know how to get your dick hard for the thing that you want.
dude, teary-eyed. Yeah. And then, you know, they did a thing where they, I'll tell you what Philadelphia whiffed for sure. What they really whiffed was that every seat had a card on it that you had to, like, hold up eventually to make something. And we had the cards, too, and we held them up, and, like, we were looking across, like, I don't know if they put the cards and the things. It was nothing. I couldn't tell you at all what the hell picture we made.
He goes, it's my art form. It would be perfect.
It was...
Lay them out exactly as I have planned.
Super, super weird. I could see Iverson where I was sitting again.
Oh, did he look over your way at all?
No. No, we were across the court, but I just saw him. I know where he sits. But
I know where he sits. I know where he eats.
Well, I knew where you were sitting last game. But he was
what
there.
A waste of a good load.
Right? Mm-hmm. You're right, Christine. What a good load that was wasted. I used to know that you said it like outside on a fucking at a podium.
What a waste of a good load.
Birds are flying by behind her.
It's like it's a press conference.
It's too early in the day for to say some shit like that.
Executive producer from the Bonfire, Christine Evans, has said, and I quote, it was a good load.
What a waste.
What a waste.
What a waste of a good load.
Joel Embiid comes out. They weren't announcing who was going to ring the bell that night to start the game before they do the intros.
So is that what they do? They ring a bell? I don't know this stuff.
They bring a Liberty bell. Yeah, well, I thought I was going to be able to do that at one point. They said there's a... Like, when I go down there, she was always like, check and see if you could actually...
So that's kind of like the opening pitch.
It's what it is, yeah. You go out and ring the little... They have a miniature Liberty bell. You go out and ring. Joel Embiid went out and did it. And I mean, you could definitely find video of that, Christine. I mean, the place was just went fucking ape shit. It was just so fucking fun. Like,
wow. Do you guys come out to that? From the bell tolls? No. How did the Sixers not come out to that?
No, I think they came out too, and they've been to Meek Mill because, like, there's so much Meek Mill stuff in the stadium.
All the players were rapping along. It was hilarious to look down. They were all rapping the lyrics.
Yeah. I'll give you a little inside info from being there. Watched Joel Embiid's pregame workout, though. He didn't play.
Yeah.
And he's not playing tonight. But with the mask on, I mean, he was literally running back and forth from three-point line to three-point line. That's what he does. He runs back and forth, and then when he gets there, they throw him two. They give him two bounce passes to hit a three.
Yeah.
And he was like, I mean, at one point, I mean, he missed a bunch, but I mean, I'd watch him go on runs of like seven in a row, just banging him, eight in a row. It was pretty crazy, man. But he goes out to ring that bell, and the place just, I just know, I've never been around that energy before. It was overwhelming. It was actually, I mean, let's laugh at me as queefy as it sounds to say, because it is, I know, but like, it was overwhelming. I was like, wow, man, this fucking city. I've never been to a playoff game of any sport.
Philly's starting
to see everybody come in, and like, yeah, like the city's just energized.
Well, you guys are also taking that title from like Boston for the first 15 years, from 2000 to 2000, like 15 or 16. Shit, even to now, they've had, I think, the best run for a sports city. Ever with Sox winning two World Series, the Bruins winning, the Celtics winning, and the Patriots being a dynasty.
Tom Brady four, right?
Five. And then
is this it? Can you hear the crowd?
Maybe you guys are starting to take that with the Eagles winning one. You guys have to win. Villanova won. If the Sixers can win a championship in the next 2 years, and the Eagles can win multiple Super Bowl titles,
oh yeah,
maybe Philly's become something.
Well, they say that listening to sports radio
Flyers,
coming back, listening to sports radio and coming back from the game. I mean, they were really like making like a whole big thing. They were like, it's like a destination again. Like it's a free agency, like, you know, wish list.
Yeah.
At this point for the city, it's just, you know, the fans are back. It's packed. Like they, you know.
Now that the Eagles have won, is it more important for you to see the Eagles win another Super Bowl or the Sixers win a championship?
In my life.
If you can only pick one.
For this year.
No. For the next 10 years, you can see the Eagles repeat, you watch the Eagles win again, or the Sixers win one.
The Sixers win one.
Okay.
Absolutely.
But the Eagles won't win a Super Bowl then.
I know, but I saw what that feels like. I got that feeling.
So now you want this one. Okay.
I'd love to feel
better. It's just a question. I just wanted to know how much it means
to you. But I mean, if you were like, would you rather have the Eagles win another Super Bowl or the Flyers win five Super Bowls? I'd be like, you could throw a grenade in the Flyers locker room. I wouldn't know who died. I don't know anything about the Flyers.
You can't count that because it doesn't mean anything.
Iverson looks like a little old man for some reason.
Hello,
there.
Oh, I'm here to represent my grandson's out.
But yeah, listen to this ovation. I mean, that's just him, like, standing up for a second. That's Matt Cord doing the announcing, by the way, who's, have you done his radio show when you do Helium in Philly?
No, but I'll be there in August, so hopefully I will.
You'll do it, yeah, Matt's great. Awesome. He's awesome, great. He's the in-house announcer. He does. I love it, man. Dwayne Wade makes a shot, and he just goes, Dwayne Wade. Like, as he just, like, he gives, like, bad announcements for them, which I fucking love. It's so great. But, yeah, you have Joel Embiid. Listen to this. I mean, this is in the crowd. I mean, it's, you know, it's... You wore a Phantom of the Opera mask.
Great.
Comes with the Phantom of the Process. Dude, I just love the... Listen, when I remember being a kid, it was one of the last times I felt this, because, you know, I had it with the Eagles. Something about, and I bet every city feels this way about their team at the moment it happens. There's something about a team that wins and does well tends to have, like, character. Nothing about the way they play. Or sometimes about the way they play, but, like...
Well, I think
when they play mean, just, like, the Sixers, what's right about this year is there's just fucking... Like, Joel Embiid is, like, an outspoken, like, Twitter junkie, like, maniac who'll just say whatever. He gets in all kinds of, like, online beefs and...
But sometimes that's good because that's, like, a little shit-talking can go a long way. If you have one of those guys, it's a perfect blend. Like, you look at teams like the 04 Red Sox when they were the idiots. Or you look at, like, the Giants in 2010 when they were just a bunch of retreads in San Francisco. And they were just, like, fun guys that just had fun playing small ball. Like, like run and dink baseball, wherever, and then they win it. And there really is something to that. Even the... Look at the...
So they have a bunch of these Eastern European dudes who are just, like... Like pinpoint, not even Easter, but, you know, Marco Bellinelli and Ersan Ilyasova.
No, but look at Sarge.
Just these guys are just banging threes while...
Look at the Eagles. You guys got, you know...
Big personality.
Chris Long and you guys doing the underdogs.
But again, even going back to 2004 when they were in the...
That was Donovan McNabb and Terrell Owens.
Right, but McNabb, Terrell Owens, but the Freddie Mitchell, remember? He went crazy, started wearing, like, the fur coats and shit. And I remember the 93... Phillies was the last baseball team I gave a shit about. And it was like Kruk, Mickey Moore, and I remember their names.
Nails.
They were all like things. Yeah, fucking, you know, the dude out in center field, Lenny Dykstra. Like, what was it? Jim Eisenreich had Tourette's. That was like hilarious.
You know, you'd so see him like
sniffling and making weird things on the plate. It was like, so 40, I think a team that wins always seems to have personality, but I don't know if that's across the board for everything. I mean,
because 49ers, growing up a 49ers fan, there never was that team of big personalities. It was kind of like everyone was nice. And they won.
Like Ricky Waters and shit.
But he wasn't a giant personality. He was just he wasn't like, Dion was the biggest personality we ever got. And that was 94. And he came in and he's one of the biggest personalities of all time. But it was like, Jerry Rice and Joe Montana, they were like, Joe Montana was good because he was so cold. And that's what fucked him as a broadcaster, because he's so cold that he's just like, okay, I'll just do this.
Montana?
Yeah.
I mean, he is just a nard.
Well, why don't you watch your mouth?
Because you're talking about say your hero.
Yeah, okay.
As dumb as a brick, I've heard.
Well, you know, I'll jump across this and lariat.
No, Jay, look, you have an opinion about that. Lariat!
But there is this, that book. I've talked about this before, but that book, Those Guys Have All the Fun, about ESPN, the oral retelling.
Mm-hmm.
They tell the story about, like, basically the bidding war that happened for Joe Montana when he became, when he stopped playing football and became a broadcaster. And then the NBC signed him and was like, this isn't good.
Yeah.
Like, it really was like Major League Two, where it's like,
mm-hmm.
hit,
mm-hmm.
caught.
Yep, up there, and yep, out. No, it does take something to have those personalities. And the Cowboys, oddly, have a lot of guys go become personalities.
Oh, I mean, they had, like, Emmitt Smith, Charles Haley, I mean.
Just all of them. There was personalities of those teams, man. And that means something, I think. And the Sixers definitely have that, the personality. But anyway, I digress. From the Sixers. Amazing win. 27-point slaughter of the Miami Heat. Hopefully more of that to come tonight. What I leaned over to Christine and said, put this name in your phone. We have to talk about this on the show. Was the young man they bring out to sing the national anthem. I'm guessing somewhere in his 70s.
Nice.
A vet of some war.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever war it is, and we can look it up, because this guy was, I mean, the shit. No legs from the knees down.
Oh.
His name is Ronald C. Brooks. He sat in a wheelchair and sang the national. I think his credential is he was the first ever Eagle Scout. Or was the first ever person to make Eagle Scout?
Aren't the Eagle Scouts after Boy Scouts?
Yeah.
Isn't that where it starts to get a little dicey when you're friends with someone? Like, I'm an Eagle Scout. You're like, you're 15, dude.
Yeah, you're in a cult.
Time's, time smoking cigarettes behind a dumpster and fight people for no reason.
You're in a cult, psycho.
Hey, fuckface. Those knots you're tying are going to be your demise. Because there's going to be one they don't teach you how to get out of.
And Christine was able to find a video of him doing this. I don't know if he does it, but man, when this guy starts getting... He sings it, it sounds a little like theatrical. But I'm telling you, when the Star Spangled Banner part gets theatrical, like once you accept, especially when you're at the game, that you're not about to watch a hot Latina sing the song mm-hmm. the way you were hoping, and you sink into this guy, I mean, this guy starts throwing his back into this song, and it is sounds and looks hilarious and awesome all at once. Ronald C. Brooks, have we looked up Christine, what he was, the first?
I'm not finding it.
Something? I think they believe he said he was the first ever Eagle Scout.
So this is the guy that sang it. This isn't obviously video from the game.
No, this isn't from the game, but this is him doing it another time. And this is, if you could play it, Christine, this is...
There's also the Eagles player named Ron Brooks, so I'm having a little hard time finding information on this Philadelphia.
Ronald Brooks. C. Brooks?
I'm going to keep looking here.
As he does the Luis J. Gomez, so you can tell who it is. It's Ronald C. Brooks.
Ron C.
It's Ronald C. Wheels out.
Now it's jarring right away because you're like, holy shit.
He looks like a Damon Wayans character.
I don't know. I mean,
you know,
really
Damon Wayans was the detective or it was just the feet and the head?
Yeah.
That's what his he's bottom a torso looks
he
like.
He is a torso in a chair.
Jacob's laughing, but he's trying not to. Am I wrong about that?
He's the only guy that does sing from his feet. He goes deeper in the diaphragm, dude. He sings from his feet.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, we'll tweet out the video.
Look how serious he looks, though, Dan. This is a serious man.
It's a patriot.
Oh, absolutely. And the first Eagle Scout. Play it, Christine. Let this give him his moment.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light.
I like it.
What so proudly
it's phonetic.
We hailed at the twilight's last gleaming.
It's everything.
Whose broad stripes and bright stars.
Now.
Through the perilous.
Right now he's giving you a serious morning.
I do think it's weird Black Lou's taking a knee. I do think that's weird. Because it is a black guy singing the song.
Now you're pointing it out, it's going to make it. It really puts a... Oh, hang on. Ronnie, hit it.
Hit it, Ron.
It is a torso singing, everybody.
Great.
That our flag was still there.
And also, I'll tell you this, and I think Christine could back this up. I believe this is years ago because he looked
a lot
older.
Hold on. Now, go.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. See his eyes go googly.
I mean,
no shit, am I right?
Fucking throws everything into it, and let me tell you this right now, he gets deadlift face on the high notes. He's like, yeah! Like the same face you make when you're fucking pulling out a final lift. Yeah!
Or the land of the free!
I mean, really?
It's one of the most difficult songs to sing.
All right.
That's why when people,
right,
I think
Sam
he
Mikkel.
Just nailed it.
No, he nailed it.
I thought you were saying me. I thought I did a good job.
Jay, you nailed it.
When I did an impression of it.
Jay, you're the voice of a generation.
But I mean, how
great
dead serious is this motherfucker about that song?
I mean, that's one of those things where you're like, this guy takes his time and cares about this song.
I mean, every word.
That's why it's funny.
It's so important to him.
When you see a 22-year-old, this guy lost his legs in a war. He's the first Eagle Scout.
I assume. That's an assumption.
No, he didn't. I'm reading
it
right now.
What are you, his ex-wife?
No, I'm sorry. I'm just reading the article.
Actually, he fucking raped a woman and a car ran over his legs.
Yeah, that was something terrible he did.
It's almost, I'm not, I don't want to say sad Soder, not Soder, but he was actually born 3 months premature, weighed 1 pound, with severely deformed legs, and he was given up for adoption and put in an orphanage for physically developmentally disabled children. And then he had.
They said he had wacky foot. They have no fucking names for it back then.
Oh no, miss, you birthed a baby that's got spaghetti legs. Oh, I've only seen this once.
Your boy's got gum tootsies.
Are you sure you didn't? Did you lay with a horse? Because the last time I saw this, we call this hair legs.
Your boy's part cuppy, I tell you. Cuppy.
No. You got a fish baby. Only way you can do this is if you can swim those legs into existence.
By the way, there's a hot chick in a wheelchair by the door.
I mean, that national anthem really was...
Fucking nailed it.
I was trying so hard not to laugh, but it was like laughter of like... pure enjoyment. Go to the end of it, Christina.
And
again.
He says his words clearly.
Yeah.
I piss out my kneecap. Yeah.
He just claps his feet flippers together at the end of it. He goes...
That's me, everyone.
Salutes them.
I mean, that guy.
Play the end of him again. Yeah. I mean. Back further. Here's where he just fucking uncorks.
Here it is.
For the land and the free.
Yeah.
And the home.
You can't not clap.
He's got no feet.
That is impressive. So his legs, he was born to a fish of a mother who let him go, put him back in the ocean.
They called him Goofy Boots. No one quite knew what to make of him.
Yeah, a fisherman found him singing on his back. He was floating in the ocean. The old man said, why, that old porta-pus, that porta-pus is singing.
It was, got a job in Tijuana flattening tortillas.
He was born without. He had his legs amputated when he was 10, and then he was actually adopted into a family at 16. And the family says, you know, we never thought of him as adopted when he was always part of the family. He went to Villanova and got a communications major.
Hey!
And apparently has a very positive outlook on life.
What a good dude.
Yeah, it says that he recalls watching Rocky and being inspired.
Initially, we hired him to be a. Initially, we adopted him to be a human carving board, but. And it turns out this guy's got some pipes on him.
My wife wanted 2.5 children, so I took the .5.
We wanted to have 2.5 kids.
He goes, we wanted the
American dream, you know?
2.5 kids and a dog. And I got my 2.5. Turns out...
I got the white picket fence with a nice house, and...
Turns out he's like the frog from Warner Brothers. You walk out of the room, he puts on a hat and sings his little... Sings his little guppy tail off.
Come on, Ron. Do the national anthem for everybody. Do the land and of the free part.
Get into it. Oh, he loves that song.
He's like, ribbit. Ribbit.
Fergie's. Stephanie Falcone wrote, he's no Fergie, but good for him.
Oh, she was ridiculous. We went through all that.
Yeah, come on.
Man, she
is. Don't you even compare guppy.
What a boob.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at her with two God-fearing legs attached to her body.
She's standing
Fuck
up.
Her.
She's standing and failing.
Yeah.
He's sitting and it's succeeding.
She could pull the power off from the floor from the energy
and
she
yes,
feels in her feet.
Yes, I did just name his personal speaking tour, Sit and Succeed. The story how one man belted out an anthem.
Coming. Coming to a local playhouse near you.
I'm going to play the role. I'll play the signature role. I will have to do blackface. It might catch some heat.
If anybody knows Ronald C. Brooks, by all means, tell him to call the show. We want to salute him. That guy sings for it.
Maybe, you know, exclude the last 20 minutes where we called him Guppy Body.
No. Oh, what are we going to do? There's no ramps here.
Yeah. There are elevators.
There's no ramps to the studio. Oh, there are elevators. I never even wrapped my brain around the idea of even getting in an elevator.
Those are doors. That move.
Those turnstiles will take his goddamn head clean off.
But if he ducks under it like fucking murder ball.
he goes back like he's going to leave and he turns around and goes running really fast. He goes, what's the son of a bitch going to do? And he just hits some weird brake thing and just like goes. He matrixes under it. Like he actually hooks under and comes back up. Yeah, how about that, you son of a bitch?
Oh, I learned while you were walking around. I was learning.
While you were running.
I was learning.
Push 36, please.
Yeah. I'm going all the way up. Did it say B2? You want to take our first break?
Yeah, because people want to talk about systems, Dan. You know what Jacob said to me? Let me tell you something there, base heads.
Yeah, everybody. This is what he said in the office for our pre-show
meeting. I don't even know if we should go back to it. It doesn't seem like anybody's going to care to talk about their systems.
I didn't say that.
Yeah, you go, people don't have systems. They don't want to talk about it. I never met a guy that likes systems that also didn't like dick in his mouth.
He goes, that's weird. That's why they have to have that base, so they can feel what it's like to get rumbling around in their bottom.
It reminds them what it feels like to have a stiff one right in their rear shitter.
Oh, they like it when when the top of their rectum vibrates, just like it does when their boyfriend's just boofing them.
Just getting tattooed in your two shoe.
Oh, you miss it, so you gotta drive around in your Honda CRX.
We'll come back. We're talking systems.
Boy, was I wrong.
Yeah, you were fucking super wrong. The phone lines are
on your favorite radio show, Bonfire.
You're goddamn right. Who else features legless singers? We're progressive as fuck.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Go, 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 go.
Seriously, get out of here. Go, go, seriously, go.
Hand and more head.
Leave, leave.
Everybody, it's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. That's Uncle Luke. That's Uncle Luke right there, bringing you the heavy hits. Thump. Oh, let your girl's booty bounce that a little bit.
Those ass cheeks.
Head, head, and mo head. I'll tell you what. Never in my life, without making fun of somebody else and saying it, have described blowjobs as head. Giving
what?
Or getting. When girls.
What?
Christine, when I met her, called it head, getting, or giving. And
yeah,
I thought it sounds so weird to me.
I call it head.
Yeah?
Yeah. I call it giving head. I give girls head. I get head.
It's a weird thing.
Why? Your head's down there.
I know, but it's
what do you
weird
call
thing.
It?
I don't
sucking.
I would say eating her pussy or sucking dick. Yeah,
that's too. That sounds medicinal.
That sounds medicinal.
Yeah,
sucking dick sounds medicinal.
It sounds like you're like,
well, doctor, I hate to speak Latin, but I was getting
penis.
My dick sucked and yeah. It started to hurt.
I'd be like, calm it down, calm it down. That's my favorite Rory Scovel line from his special, where he goes, "Oh, I didn't know I was talking to a lawyer, doctor." Anal? He's like, I call it butt fuck.
my lower back is hurting so bad. I'm sitting. Like, weird in my
why?
Chair. If you're wondering why,
it's
I'm
a weird thing to say after
diving. It hurts. I don't know. My back hurts. I was blessing my back out. Doo doo brown.
You got doo doo brown.
I was getting hair.
You getting pegged?
Hair and
yeah,
mohair.
I don't think it's called giving. Calling it head's not weird to me.
And mohair.
I mean, more head. Mohead's weird.
Head, head,
and mohair.
Yeah, my back hurts. People, that song came into my life when Little Jay was cruising through Valley Brook in South Jersey on my way to my mom's house, and he was, you'd hear him coming down the street a mile away with just these stupid bass tubes and big
dude,
just wooden and carpeted, just self-made wooden boxes,
yeah,
with speakers in them, just thumping in a car that was purchased for $300 at Autobahn Market, or whatever the fuck.
Did you ever see
they were all when you go to the auctions?
Yeah, cop auctions. That's where I got the Honda Accord hatchback.
Yeah, yeah. An auction's a great place, and just
cop
Jay
auction,
thumping down the road in this this song.
Did you ever see old Saturns were made of like plastic,
fiberglass
or like something.
Yeah.
So when someone had a Saturn with a system, it sounded awful.
Oh, it would just rattle the trunk.
Because the fiberglass would be like rattling and then already rattling. So
you
like,
hear all the fucking. You hear all the strings in it. Those little.
You're like, this is not fun. This is.
It was almost good and nothing at all for nothing.
Watch someone had a Saturn with a system and is listening to this, like, this fucking guy, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I'm just saying, the one time I rode a Saturn with a system, I was like, this is awful.
Danny Rosini was the kid that got.
What a great full name.
Danny Rosini was a good one. He had a Monte Carlo that was like, first of all, he was so tiny. I think it was pituitary issue.
Okay.
Really
tiny. He was Webster shit, huh?
No, not like Webster, but just like the kid that, like, I'd be curious to see what he looks like now. It would be.
Look him up!
Pretty hilarious.
Danny Risotto.
But he was, yeah, I kept growing, and we were buddies, and still he's a great kid. Fucking hilarious kid.
Yeah.
And, but he was, yeah, very short, and just in a Monte Carlo SS, and he was the one, like, thumping, like, you know, he'd like,
Monte Carlos and Cadillacs, I feel like, were the best cars for those.
For the thumps?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. Like, but
low and wide.
Well, he did go for more of a system, not necessarily for, like, rather you could listen to, like, rock on it. But it is funny, at the time of systems, like, if not a lot of people rode around thumping rock.
No.
It was like, a very particular kind of music.
Yeah.
Right, hip-hop or the freestyle that I'm going to be playing for you on the next commercial break. I'm so excited. I remember so many of these songs, dude. You would just need, like, one tape of, like, a now. I mean, that's what now, that's what I call music is made for.
Oh, yeah.
It's made for one CD you can put in to just pick up a fucking doofy other, like, 16-year-old.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're, like, 16, you buy that and play that music, and then another 16-year-old will go, it's like, oh, my God, you know the new song by whoever, whoever?
Yeah.
By DJ Arithmetic.
Yeah, it's really.
He's addicted. He's addicted to uppers and downers.
Yeah, I never had a system. In fact, even at the time when my friends did have systems, I was broke enough. I drove my mom's Chevette, and in the back seat, I put my D battery operated boombox.
Great.
With a CD or a tape.
That's great.
Playing in my backseat. And by the way,
I had a friend that did that.
Get out on the open road, though. I'll tell you what, get on a highway coming from like Philly to South Jersey or something. You still listen to it. You're like, all right, well, it's good.
What was it? What
makes me wish I smoked cigarettes in high school because I would have enjoyed that on those long. I did a lot of long car rides without cigarettes, so I could have just.
No way, man. Drive it and
never
smoke.
Changed.
By the time I started driving, I was already smoking. It was the best.
Yeah.
Oh, driving and smoking is the. It's only second to shitting
one.
And smoking.
I miss that one pretty good.
Driving.
I don't drive a ton though, so it's not so bad, but like
driving, yeah, that's when I'm glad that cloves exist just to have some sort of replacement.
Yeah. Dude, this is the song. I figure this is what's always happening in DJ Lou's head all weekend. This is just happening.
It's just him, but then it's just him shirtless watching a Mets game smoking.
Hey! You want to come over to my place to hang out?
I'm drunk as shit.
It's a full party. I never had. I got like when after I got a car, the money that I saved up, I got a CD face, like a deck. I bought like an Alpine deck.
You didn't get a changer in the back?
No. I couldn't afford it. Oh, and I got two little speakers in the front because they were blown out in my Dodge Stratus, so I had to get new speakers. 7.9s, or what are they called? 7.9s?
Yeah.
Is that a speaker?
9x7s? 7x9s?
I don't know, dude. I don't know this world. But I'll tell you what, this guy, is Rod on the phone? Because Rod's...
Yeah, buddy. Yeah. Rod's on the phone.
He texted me his specs.
Yeah?
And it's fucking hilarious.
Shit was nice?
I mean, pick up the phone. Let's have him run
Yo,
through.
Rod, what's up? You're on the bonfire, man.
Welcome to System Talk on the bonfire.
Yo, what are you pushing?
Yeah,
that's what you say. Yo, what are you pushing?
I was pushing a Pioneer face, pull-out face. Had a six-disc CD changer in the back. I had a Big Red. Now, if you know what's up with the cars, if you had a Big Red, that means you had the biggest dick on the yard.
You goddamn right, Rod. And let me ask you a question, Rod, before you do it. What was in that six-disc changer? I'm going to ask all the callers to tell us, what were you thumping so DJ Lou can put it on while you tell your story?
Sweet.
What were you thumping, Rod?
We're going to go back to 1999.
All right.
I was playing BG Bling Bling.
Yeah. Every time I come around, you say, bling, bling. Yeah. Oh, that's the cash money is an army. It's a navy.
Go ahead.
So
bling, bling's clicking.
So if you had this, there's one way to make your shit really click. If your shit really kicked, you had an EQ in there. I had a Serum Vega EQ, and I had Serum Vega with...
What's the name of it again?
Serwin Vega.
Okay.
EQ. And then you hit that EQ, and all your bass, or your whole car rattles.
Oh,
Oh, dude, that's those are the ones that gave me heart palpitations when I was smoking weed in that Yukon, where it's like,
yeah, like, you can't catch a breathing rhythm again. I'm exhaling on the inhale. I don't know, it's not happening.
It's like learning how to swim in cold water.
Go and go. That was a big thing, Ron. I do remember that a lot of the things you did when someone had a good system that you didn't realize was going on was that shit right there, like those the EQs, the amps. The amp was a big deal, my friends. I know they would give the numbers on it. I didn't know what it meant, but the amps. And then they started doing and I'd say it was a little past my years, my age of people giving a shit about systems.
Yeah.
Was then they started making those pieces of electronic showboat stuff too. Where like the amp, even though it just sits there, it doesn't thump at all. It's just a metal thing basically.
Oh, but it had the
lights. Had like neon light on it and stuff like that. Am I right, Rod?
Yep, I had a neon light. And if you want to take your shit even further, so this is back in like 99, 2000, 2001.
Stop saying back. I was expecting a child at that time. I was way past system age.
Everybody was getting decals on the side of their cars. I had a 98 Trans Am, a purple 98 Trans Am.
Oh, nice. Perp.
With T-tops, the two T-tops, I had blacked out 20-inch rims.
Oh.
I was rolling, and my boys, all of us had the Trans Ams. All of us had Trans Ams.
Wait, really? You guys all had different Trans Ams? Was it all different colors, like Power Rangers?
Because you can get them crazy cheap at that time. That's why my friend Little Jay always had a Trans Am. You can get them cheap, and it looked like you were driving a sports car.
Yeah.
Yep. Now, we had Twix on the side. I had Twix on the side of my car. My homie had Skittles on the side of
That's so funny, dude. That's so funny because...
we wore the matching racing jackets.
Dude, Rod, I try to tell people this. People forget about when black dudes rocked NASCAR jackets to the mid-aughts, to like 07, 08. That fucking Russian joke that I wrote when I was in the Bronx and those three dudes came around the corner, they were all wearing NASCAR jackets. That's why I started laughing.
That is really fucking hilarious.
One of them came around in a fucking Tide jacket. I was like, I'm white trash. I know where this is. Like, I know who the real fan base of this.
Dude, the decals thing.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite stories. When I started doing comedy, which was in 99.
Yeah. So around the time that Rod was just
Rod, how old are you?
I'm 34.
34, okay, yeah. So in 99, when my friends were doing all the decal shit,
yeah,
my friend had one. That's the story I may have told on the air before, but, you know, I was sort of the thing with my friends that kept them, like, tethered somehow to not sounding silly all the time. Like, we're talking to a bunch of, like, suburban kids who were saying things like, yo, we're about to rumble with this neighborhood. That's and you're like, like, guys, we're 18, 19, man. Like, that sounds like a stupid thing to say. We're rumbling with... Why is this exactly, you know?
Oh, yeah, because they go to a different high school?
Yeah, it's like, so it was a lot of that kind of shit going on. And one time, my buddy Mike Vada came back, his Maxima. He threw a decal on the back. It was some version of 2M, the number 2 and an M.
Yeah.
And I was like, what does that mean? He goes, it's just the logo, which I thought was pretty cool. I think I got to put it on there. I mean, he really, Chris Farley showed me.
Yeah.
I was like, but 2M, it seems very specific. Like, your name's not 2M's. I'm like, your name's Mike Vada. I was like, MV would make more sense. I would get that to some degree.
Mean Mike?
He's like, no. He's like, it's just a logo. He couldn't think of a good lie. It's just a logo. And then I said, it's like one of my friends who believed in what it was, who cared more than embarrassing himself with me, that wanted me to know what it was.
Yeah.
And it was the group of these townhouse living on a golf course white kids that decided to call themselves the Second Mafia.
That's great.
2M.
Dude.
Second Mafia. And dude, my friend told me, I couldn't wait to go back there because I liked that he was the personality that I can go, what are you doing? He's like, I mean, I don't really care about it. I just like the logo. Like, nah, dude, you way care. It's on the back window of your thing, and it's not even a danger. I might even tell you to take it off because it's not dangerous because no one's looking for the Second Mafia.
I mean, what an awful name of a group.
One time I was driving back from New York. I'd already started going to New York. And I would drive by down Black Horse Pike to go back to my mom's house at night. And I'd pass this place with the Philly Diner. Still such a great diner. The Philly Diner. And sometimes I'd see their cars there. So I would go in and, like, hang out with them for a little bit sometimes. And, like, one of them went to the bathroom once and left, like, a composition notebook on the table.
No.
And I started thumbing through it.
Was it Sick Rhymes?
Dude, no. Some of them actually were pretty angry at me for a while after, because I was just so laughably at their fake gang.
Yeah.
Because I went through it, and I swear to you, in the back, it was like the second Mafia's, like, you know, whatever chapter or something. And it was like, you know, it'd be like Ernie, treasurer, like so and so.
Dude, that's great.
Secretary takes the minutes of all the meetings. Like, everyone had like a position.
They legitimately had minutes.
It was like henchmen. If I'm lying, then I've convinced myself I've made it. You know what I mean?
Dude, like, that is
it,
so great. Where he goes, can you check the back of the mead? What does it have? Have I been bumped up? I don't know if you saw on the fourth page, but there's an airplane war that he drew.
I just know it's when the kid sick. Came out of the bathroom, unfurled on him, just like laughing at him and making so many other people laugh at them. And
Sub-Mafia?
And they were like, and they were saying things too. It's like, I don't know, dude, you come there and you just cross us. Oh, it was so, and you're like, you guys know,
dude.
My mom buys us pizzas once in a while. Dude, like, what are you guys talking about?
I would have loved to have been the same age and known you, so we could have started the third Mafia, and then another group of friends start the fourth Mafia, and then just keep doing it to where there was like eighth and ninth.
The third Mafia would have ruled.
The third Mafia would have been the best.
But it's funny, you know, it's how my brother got fucking mixed up with drugs and shit. His thing was more being a follower than, he was never like a goofy, like, wigger kid or anything like that. He's just like, but all those kids, like, I know some of those kids are still all fucked up on drugs and shit and still all messed up, and a lot of people died down there. And it's because they go, fuck, man, we're tough too, like the city. It's like, just don't be, man. Just go to college and be fine.
Man, suburban boredom gets a lot of good kids into some dumb shit.
So, I'm telling you, I grew up in, that's what was funny, I grew up in right in West Philadelphia. And by the way, the neighborhood was like, I remember when I was a kid, everyone played outside together. Yeah. And the neighborhood essentially just went black, like, in my lifetime. You know what I mean? When I was there, but we were still there. My grandmother's still there. You know what I mean? It is what it is. But I mean, I don't think I'm like a hardened street kid either. But growing up there, when I went, being 17 years old, when I moved to Jersey, I was already like, you know, I've lived what I thought was like a life at that point. Yeah. My friends, my personality, whatever. But when I got to, that's what I thought was so funny. In my mind, I was like, oh, wow, good. We got out of this neighborhood that it was getting dicey for the last couple years, you know. And with that point would have been like, you know, a third of my life.
Yeah.
It's starting to get a little dicey. You know, I'm happy we're moving to South Jersey. And then you find all these goofy white kids, man, that would just, they couldn't wait to be like, what do you mean? We're fucking tough. We're tough kids. Like, city kids. And they all did drugs. And I was like, I don't know. People smoked weed back in Philly a little bit that I knew of. But I didn't know of a lot of people smoking. And definitely didn't seem like everybody was like, no heroin and all that shit. And that was a big problem in the school I went to for 1 year in South Jersey. Several kids died from heroin.
But that's what I was saying. My friends that were like the bad kids that I told you about in middle school were just bored suburban kids that would go smash windows and shit. And you're like, what are you guys doing? And finally when I started hanging out with my group of friends from high school, they were like, I was like, oh, you guys are still kind of kids. You're still kind of like, you're high school kids. You're not like trying to be bad. You're not trying to do. And it was like those were the kids that all had systems, were the kids that were like, yeah, dude. But they're the ones that got me, you know, smoking cigarettes at 11, 12 years old and smoking weed at 13.
System kids get laid too once in a while. Dude, system will get you some pussy. Give a call in if your system got you some puss. Just a girl. That was the whole idea. That's why you bump this shitty, stupid music you hear in the background.
Yeah.
Is because girls would, like, at the mall, you drive around, you do laps around the malls and see if girls would look. And you just look at them. You let the music talk for you. Your in-car strobe lights going.
I was always just the shithead in the passenger seat, shoulder dancing.
I'll tell you what, before we take this commercial break, I'm going to text my friend Glenn was texting me today, and I should have reminded him to call in.
Oh, yeah.
About his fucking, we can tell you the story. We should,
Thanks for calling in, Rod.
Thank you, Rod. Yeah, we're going to talk more. I think we should stay on systems. It's a fun conversation.
Well, Black Lou's got one that just, his face just blew up. Is that a good one?
I was looking for some old photos because I used to be in a car club.
Dude, holy fucking shit.
We were called Visual Impact. And then we were called Underground Custom.
Of course you were.
Dude, and I just found like old photos of me on MySpace.
Then we were called the Upstate Sabres.
We were called the Aurora Barons.
The Barons.
Let's come back with Black Lou's car club shit, because
God damn. I love that you have this checkered past that you don't play for us.
He was pushing a system, yo.
Terrible taste.
Thanks for the call, Rod.
Terrible taste in black women. Let's see if this taste in the system is
The black better. Women list is in heavy question this weekend. That was quite a debate I saw online. We'll be right back, everybody.
Shoulder dancing.
It's the bonfire. Girl, I want you in my world. Baby, you must stay. And don't leave and go away. I need you more each day. I need to hear you say that I love you. Take me.
Hey, Jay. Why would you do that?
And now, back to the bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Feel that thump. You feel that thump, Danny Sodes? Where you at? Yo, you putting 2% tin on those windows? That shit ain't street legal. I call you Flames. Flames Soder. Right, the big boobs. Hey, everyone, it's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95.
This is the radio show with the most bass.
Thumping, keeping you thumping through your work day with comedy that punches you right in the heart and dick.
Oh, you want your taint jiggled? Yeah, this is the radio show.
You want to listen to music that makes you think you might have to shit?
No.
Well, you dialed into the right show, motherfucker. You're hanging out with Dan Soder, who's going to be at the Rhode Island Comedy Connection October 27th and 28th.
Vibrating glasses off the table.
And then the Loft Comedy Club in Chicopee, Massachusetts, April 29th. You can catch him at the Comedy Mix in Vancouver, May 3rd through May 5th. Let it thump through your soul. For tickets and all other tour dates, you go visit DanSoder.com.
Boom, 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 boom. Big J. Oakerson gonna be booming them at Hilarities. April 26th through April 28th. After that, take this explosion of bass to Caroline's on Broadway.
Broadway.
New York City. Get ready.
NYC.
Get ready for the boom. May 3rd through the 6th. Tickets and other tour dates. Go to your bass loving needs at BigJ.com.
Don't forget about Billions on Showtime.
Billions.
It's no time like Showtime.
Billions
Sunday nights.
Boom.
Oh, Austin, Texas, you think we wouldn't tickle your tits a bit? Guess who's coming to the Moon Tower Festival this weekend?
Friday, April 20th, boom, down in Austin.
Boomtown! It's Boomtown! Austin, Tejas!
I do like that someone probably has a shitty system and like blown out speakers and they're listening in their car. And that was just all rattling. But they're just driving, they're going, stop it, Lewitsky. Stop.
Expect to see the building in New York crumbling.
It's like, why is everything...
Oh, fantasy girl.
All right. Okay.
Dave in Illinois. He wants to talk systems. Before we talk systems, Dave, why don't you tell us what was thumping in your system so DJ Lou can look it up?
Man, bro, I had the Rockford Fosgate.
Wait. Before we get your specs.
Let me just say out the box, I respect.
Oh, a Fosgate?
Dude, you got a Fosgate?
My box?
Yeah, now what were you bumping?
What were you thumping?
Bumping or thumping?
Fucking, shit, I'm from Chicago area, so like you were just humping Stevie B and like the Suzy Q shit, that was your pussy stuff, then your classic masterpiece shit will blow your system to hell. Obviously, Jay, you called it, man, on the fucking Metallica shit. Because that when you heard one in there, it was a whole nother double kick drum.
It was different
going on.
Yeah,
yeah,
it hurt.
It was like a whole nother experience.
Yeah, and I got a nosebleed.
Yeah, dude, got a nosebleed
from rock. Ass,
like the JL Audio fucking 12, like forearms, dude. Them motherfuckers are like $6 a piece almost.
Really? How much money did you put into your car? How much money did you put in your car total?
Well, dude, I had inherited a shitload of money from my dad because he passed away when I was little.
Okay.
And it built up. So I had got, like, the brand new Black Blazer in 96, which is, like, the first SUV. I had that motherfucker pimped out. I had the vent visors and shit. I put some 15s were pimping, though, then.
Yeah, 15s were 20. They were the, that was the 90s 20s.
yeah, because they made those in the, okay. No, but, yeah, man. We had that, and then I had the Clarion deck. It was like the first one where you didn't have to...
I remember the Clarion deck. Was that the one that flipped around where it looked like it didn't exist, where you could like touch it, and then it would like come out and flip and then look like it's not there?
Or you could deface it, and then you could change the colors and shit.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
I remember those.
And then all it had was the AV jacks. You couldn't like hook it to the regular door speakers.
Oh.
You had to run the AV. You had to run the AV all the way back. And then bridge it out through your crossover, and then run your stick through your front.
Dude,
Christine.
Dude, I love that he's going so deep. He goes, "Nah, it's where AV wire splits." I think this show just turned into a union game.
He's like, "Ask Christine. It's a real clit tickler."
Yeah. He goes, "What she's feeling running through under that seat is pure power."
You know, it's hilarious. For the sake of reference, it is funny, though, isn't it, that at that time, even Dave here is supporting that in your car, you would have Suzy Q, which that's what you should play, Lou, is little Suzy Q in the background. But you'd have like Suzy Q and Johnny B and that kind of shit. Or Johnny O, which is what I'm going to show you in a second, by the way. That was Fantasy Girl by Johnny O. Though you'd have those songs for the right, you know, for your laps around the mall, but then you got to go on the highway for a minute before you go to the mall, and that's where you thump. But people then had those two songs and everything in between. Do you get what I mean? Like, I had Counting Crows and fucking Megadeth and fucking... It just doesn't exist anymore. It's not a thing.
Systems, like, it's in my thing. Neighborhood, it was all... What you'd hear the most was, like, West Coast rap. So, like, 2001...
I don't practice Santa... have no crystal... Summertime and the living's easy...
A lot of good bass in Sublime.
You know what I love about Christine is she doesn't get super SoCal until we start trashing Sublime. And there's like a part of her that goes, okay, but like, seriously, there's like, guys, but Bradley Noel was, he did a lot of good stuff.
It was great bass.
I don't know about that.
It's great bass.
He left his child and died of heroin.
It's overdose, great bass, but. Though, because he used to nod out on his strings. I'm up.
Should we keep it?
I'm up.
My friend that had the best system, he was way into metal, so it was like he'd play like I remember Roots, Bloody Roots was a big one he'd blast.
Yeah,
that's weird. Yeah, but isn't that weird? I'm telling you now, though, like there's not people are into one kind of thing completely. Dave, thanks for the call, buddy.
Yeah, it was so nice. I met you guys in Chicago. It's my 40th birthday, man. You guys made
hell yeah, dude. Happy birthday, brother. Dude.
Welcome to 40.
Thanks, Soder.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Soder and Big J, man. You guys made my shit, man.
Oh, thank you, brother.
Good meeting you, dude, and happy birthday, bud.
Pleasure, man. Go do something weird. Soder, do something weird for your birthday.
Yeah, go get those bumps and the thumps.
Yeah. Boom. I got you a Rockford Fosgate amp. It's in the mail.
Yeah, dude, I'm sending you 212s and a JBL fucking Surge Guard.
And Tyler's been waiting on the phone for a long time. This is what I just want you to know. Jacob says no one's going to be interested in talking systems.
No one cares
about systems.
Tyler's
been on hold for 52 and counting 27 seconds. 52 minutes, 27 seconds. Tyler in Ohio. Please. What were you thumping?
Tyler, please hang up.
Hey, what's up, guys?
It'd be great if you just hung up. Fuck you. Boom.
What were you thumping through your system?
Well, actually, my system wasn't in my car. When I was a freshman in high school, all the seniors got all their subwoofers together out of their cars, and they put it in our locker room for basketball. So on the floor of the locker room, we had like three car batteries, and it was all hooked up. And when I was, I played on the freshman team and the JV team, so when the varsity would go into the stretch and stuff before the game, their music and their subwoofers would play and shake the gym, which is like right beside the locker room, and all like the backboards, all the fans were trying to figure out where this music was coming from, and it would like rock the whole gym.
Did you guys were thumping music in the locker room? This is Maury. Is this Tyler Maury?
Yeah, what's up, buddy?
Yeah, buddy. That's the whitest trash thing I've ever heard, Tyler. I gotta be honest with you.
Yeah, car battery to fucking.
By the way, all on the floor of a wet locker room. That sounds like a Final Destination movie.
Yeah,
scene.
He goes, oh, don't worry, we're running the wires through the shower, so nothing wrong could happen.
What's good? What can go wrong with speaker wires and a bunch of feet and wet tile?
Oh my God, Black Lou.
What the fuck, Black Lou?
Oh my God, dude. Tyler, was this only for basketball games you guys would do this?
Yeah, and we got in trouble after like the first game because all
yeah, probably because you guys fucking because the electric bill from the high school is $400,000.
Someone tells me the fencing team wasn't bumping music in the locker room. Like
do you
that.
Guys
right,
know?
Right.
Do you guys know if the choir was bumping those 16-12s in the locker room?
Hey, I don't mean to say, but I saw some pretty sparky wires on the floor back there. Is that going to be a thing? Should I be grounded?
I don't want to freak you guys out, but I think whoever put the 17-12s in the locker room conjured up a lake monster over about 3 miles in. I think you guys woke him from his century-long sleep.
He conjured up a ring.
Yeah. Thanks for calling in, Tyler.
Yes, thanks for the call, buddy. This picture we have up here, and by the way, the Bonfire SXM.
Good for you, Lou.
on Twitter and Instagram, please. I mean, Black Lou, we found a picture of him making...
R&B face. That is such R&B face. Oh my God!
Is that your wife? Is that your wife?
No. That's a girl I dated for a little while.
Yeah. Again, good for you, Lou.
Thanks, man.
I mean, you are wearing a face like you should be wearing a wife beater and billowy white silk pants.
You guys are wearing matching pit crew outfits.
Yeah, you guys look like you're on a shitty bowling team.
We bought those together, you know, for the car club. Oh. The car club had their own.
What came first, her or the car club?
She did.
And then she got you to join the car club?
No, she basically helped me with the car club. But.
So car club was your idea, and then she jumped in to help out and become part of it.
Yeah.
A lot of people were calling them the Jay and Christine of car clubs.
Yeah, I heard that. I'm the car.
Did you create the car club? Like, well, it was your group that you started and invited people to join?
Yes. Yeah. So
was that your car? Was that your car, Black Lou, in the picture?
No, that was my buddy of mine car.
Because that thing looks all kinds of decked out on the front.
Yeah, that looks like that's like some speed racer shit.
So we had a car club called Visual Impact first, and then we joined up with someone that had a shop.
Were you guys street racing?
Every now and then.
No,
it was more
just to
like
show
pull
off
up
your
to
shit.
Wendy's and show your shit off for a little while, eat some Wendy's food. And,
that's so funny because yeah. I was always the stone guy in the 96 Dodge Stratus going, who spends this much money on their car?
Me
you
too.
Can buy drugs.
He goes, yo, man. He goes, your car ain't shit unless you got a big ass fin.
Yeah, I go.
They got
yeah.
a fin on the back.
Oh, dude, can you crawl into your car on your knees? No, then it ain't worth the shit.
Do you have a ceiling fan in your car?
I got four speakers in the back. I got four display screens in the back, and you can't. It's a two seater.
I got an HVAC system.
That was always the thing with like Pimp My Ride cars, where you're like, they seem so useless. All of this seems so
completely.
Useless.
We got defibrillators. We got
actually that's a bus schedule from Toledo. That is
I got a random menu from a place called Manny's, which is a pretty good Peruvian steakhouse.
Oh, this is an old movie listing from 1997. If you want to know what's going on at Seven Hills Movie Theater.
You smell the seat there, you can see a fart I left in 85.
Yeah.
Good. I'm sorry.
I had the slowest car because I had like a two-seater Honda Civic.
Yeah.
And everyone else just had faster cars than I did. So I'd be in the back, but I was cool because I was like almost like the car club, like lookout. So okay. I bought this scrolling marquee from eBay,
yeah.
and I hooked it up to my car battery,
yeah.
and I set like remote settings that would say like "slow down, cops ahead," or like yeah, and it would just scroll across my back window. So I
really?
Glued it to my window, and I had a scrolling marquee. So everywhere I went, if I wanted to signal just someone behind me, I can just push a button.
Yeah,
and they would be behind you?
They'd be either behind me, beside me, in front of me.
That's why they let your,
how we were rolling that.
That's why they let your bullshit slow car stay in the club, because you would be the fucking...
They go, he's a lookout. We need a lookout.
He's a lookout. They go, Hey, man, how's my car looking? Is it dope? I don't know if you guys saw, but I put clap lights on the side. Yeah. And they're like, yeah, dude, no, it's super great.
Hey, Lou, no, I like checking my stocks when I drive to the side of you. I like that you put all the upcoming news right on the side of the car.
Hey, did you guys see all the Marvin the Martian stickers I put on my door? Hey, yeah, dude, it's great.
Hey, Black, he updates his scrolling marquee with other stuff. He goes, can you put up some movie times? We're trying to see if we want to go see Time Cop.
We're trying to see if we can make it to.
He goes, oh,
trying to get to a late Justice League.
He goes, there's a 9:30 and 11:45. Yeah, we got to get to 11:45. That's the last one.
Hey, my white girlfriend wants to know if I, Tanya's playing at maybe an art house theater in this neighborhood.
I mean,
there's no art house theater here. Well, oh my God, that is going to be something to really talk about when we go to the seafood restaurant.
So you got this car club going, and then did she jump in, this ex-girlfriend? Was she like, fuck yeah, I'm in. This is awesome.
No, it took a little convincing. She kind of hated it at first because we were trying to get new members so fast.
Jumping
so we printed out business cards, and if we thought your car was cool, like if we went to the movies and thought your car was cool, we'd leave a business card on your window.
Oh.
Like, oh, we're looking for you to join up with our car club. Like, it'd be so great. Yeah. Love your car. No one ever called us.
Now, what's the club? No one ever called? What's the club? Did you guys have meetings and stuff? Were you guys like, were you Second Mafia organized?
We were pretty
organized.
Second
Mafia had a notebook with all people's positions.
You know, there was a notebook, and it was a classic black and white composition, if you were wondering. There wasn't no bullshit. They didn't come in no funny colors like some broad.
Yeah.
That's not how they fucking got down.
They don't draw markers with ponies on the
back. That's not how the Second Mafia got down, dog. And so, I see you making side eyes at me, Jacob. You want me to call them up right now?
Dude.
Let me see you say that shit to their faces.
90-minute drive away from here.
Let me see you say that to their scabby meth head faces.
Yeah. If they haven't picked off their scab, I bet they will and they'll throw it at you.
Is when that a great white on the shark, on the car hood?
Yeah.
I mean the black blue, they're all great whites.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you mean the picture. I thought you meant
the fish, not his conquest.
I thought you meant the white girl next to him.
Yeah. He goes, "Ooh, I got a white." That's how he measures him to his other black friends. He goes, "Ooh, I got a great white."
This one's more of a squall.
Yeah. He goes, "This is a nurse shark." Gonna bite it and not let go. I love that you saw the shark. I didn't know what the design was, and then Jacob goes,
"What is that one?"
Yeah, now I see. Yeah,
Jacob goes,
"Is that a Atlantic great white? Whoever drew it fucked up. Dorsal fin looks all fucked up."
So you convinced her to join the car, and then she got into it.
Basically, yeah.
When she broke up, was she like, "And your car club is fucking stupid"?
She might have said that a couple times.
Did she do that thing?
After the breakup?
Yeah.
Oh, doesn't that suck when you get them into something and then they turn on you for it?
She threw the little smock back at me and shit.
Oh, your pit crew shit?
Yep.
Was her name embroidered?
It was embroidered.
Oh.
I faked every one of my oil stains.
Yeah. Good times, though. Good times.
Did she ever get naked and squat, fuck your, what do you call that, the gear shift?
No. I wish, though.
Why didn't you ask her to?
She wasn't that kind of girl. She was very, prim and proper.
Car sluts love that. There's so much video of girl fight. That means something to a guy. Guys who dig cars, like, they're chick.
No.
Dude.
Fucking the gear shift?
App. So, absolutely.
You think guys that are in the cars are like
that? Men travel to Japan to fuck robots. So, I mean,
they're an octopus, but yeah. But the octopus are the, everyone knows that they're the knowledgeable creatures of the sea. That's why they're
the most.
Arms.
They're the ones that'll throw the most emotion into fucking.
Yeah, everyone knows that it means something to octopuses. You don't go fucking eel. The eel don't care. Octopus. That's some suction.
You got a girl
suction
fucking
on the
car.
There's no way, girl. Like, you're saying it like it means something. Like, please fuck my gear shift.
Absolutely.
Please fuck my gear shift.
Yeah. No. It means to the guy. Yeah. That is, your chick's like fucking your car. Yeah. Look. Is that really her noise?
Yo! I looked up from my phone.
Oh, it's so warm. Wow, she got a little weird fur on the inside lips. She must not know it was gonna be picture day.
I mean, that whole gear shift is in there.
Yeah. Now it's a sport shift, Dan. So yeah.
She's not a slut. I mean, that thing is mobbed up like it's a sloth. Oh, look at that. It looks like an alien eating something.
Yeah, it really pushes in.
It looks like a rabbit.
Man, look at that pasty chick.
Oh, what happened?
Bounce it on you. Oh, yeah, do the one in the butt.
No.
Christine,
there's always
do
Jacob
the
and
one
I,
in the butt.
Jacob and I are...
I feel like I had a pop-up open somewhere.
Wow, good for her.
Yeah.
By the way, that's just vinyl and or leather going straight up her shitter. I don't know what you lube up for that.
She goes, my ex-boyfriend's 70.
Yeah, guy.
Yeah. Back in the home. Dude, I mean, wow.
It's a whole section.
I mean, this is a thing.
Yeah.
I
didn't know. I mean, of course, Jay knew.
I knew. You want me to deny that? I'm wildly aware.
She's condoming up.
Yeah, finally, an adult.
What a waste of a good load.
Right? Oh, dude.
She's like, now squirt windshield wiper fluid on my face.
She's
that's a bad shave job.
Am I a bad? There it is.
Every one of these girls has had a bad shave job so far. There's been one good looking pussy who's willing to fuck a gear shift.
There has to be a guy where he's driving the next day. He goes, yeah. He's just grabbing his gear shift.
He goes, when you take a break, you go to bite a nail while you're at a red light. You're like, ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yesterday.
Oh, yeah. She got to working on it.
Yeah, that definitely means something to some dude that you fuck his car. But I don't know. I do think there's probably, I bet you make a little sacrifice on looks for a girl who's
willing to fuck a gear shift.
Oh, you know what though? Not with, there's no faces. Is there any girl that shows her face in a gear fucking video? Because that would be a big difference. Not showing your face, it's almost anonymous.
No, I like
a girl to fuck an emergency brake.
Yeah,
but I'm a safety file, guys. Yeah. I'm a safety file.
I mean, there she goes. Look at that. Why does it look like her pussy was in the oven for too long?
Yeah, what the hell's going on?
Why does it look crisped at the end?
Did she shave?
Nom, 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 nom. This Honda.
Is that hair?
Don't you understand? These robot cars are having sex with all the girls.
They're taking on fucking women.
I don't know if I can. If you had sex with a car, I don't know if I could be with you.
I thought they were just fighting for ownership over what was the name of their planet. God damn it.
Don't you understand? I'm not worried about these cars. I'm worried about them having sex with our women and having robot car babies.
Should we take our last break? Yeah,
let's take our last break. Come back.
We talked systems. That shit was mad dope. Rockford Fosgate.
Hell yeah, but we're coming back with an old favorite from the show. Or I should say, an old favorite from my show.
Hi.
Something went popping off during the weekend.
Shit's popping off in the world of Cash Me Outside. We'll cash you on the other end of this commercial break. Because it's the bonfire.
Hell of a job, dude.
Thanks, bro.
Can I be honest?
Thanks. Hell of a job. Either one. Either one. Hell me on.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, so much bass. Your heart is just rattling. You're my dream girl. Johnny O on the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, and that's the master of bass, Big J. Okerson.
Master of the B.
Master of the B. Emma the B. Johnny O, that's what he looks like?
Dude, how great is that?
Dude, that's so funny. That's what he looks like? What does he even look like?
He looks like a...
I'm trying to, like, put it together. It's just so creepy looking. Looks like a Mater D.
It looks like Zorro, the gay blade.
Yeah, he really does. That mustache and that hair. There he is. Johnny O, just giving it up.
Look at that crust ass stash.
Dude, and that fucking full on party mullet.
He's got a late 80s El DeBarge.
He really does. Got the finger wave.
I mean, is anybody who did this kind of music not a gay man?
Look at those moves, though. Look at that dipshit.
Oh, at the bonfire. SXM. Tweet that video out. Oh.
I mean,
hips, hands, all
it's
of
like
it.
It's like Beyonce before Beyonce was a thing.
Don't say that. Beehive will come after you.
Man,
I'm just saying Johnny O did it first.
Dude, his pants are pleated. Holy shit.
I think they're more pleat than pants.
They really, I mean, they're every...
What if I told you he turned pants into pleats?
He became... Where did Johnny O go?
He went into the pleats. Never was saw him seen again. Don't you understand? There are two worlds. There are our world and inside the pleats.
But dude, how crusty does Johnny O look? What does he look now? Any picture of Johnny O now?
You got a recent Johnny O pic?
Did he die from, you all know what we're thinking. From the funk? I think he got skewered by Dick.
Are you saying he was Dick Roadkill? That was the sound of Brazilian Dick.
It looks like he's playing the Queen Mary in Los Angeles. Sick.
Fuck yeah.
Sick. He's also on a tour with MC Hammer, the Sugar Hill Gang, and 10 others.
Johnny O!
10 others. That's a motherfucking tour.
Whoa!
What a please show this tour. George Lamond, that's a pants creamer for you want to fuck a 40-year-old chick wearing mom jeans?
Oh,
there
yeah.
you go, buddy. Wait, 40? Go back to that list.
That's a 50-year-old, dude.
You can get a 50-year-old, too. No, dude, that was all...
The Flirts, Lisa?
Lisa. Robin S. You gotta be good. You gotta be strong.
That's Desiree.
Yeah, I just was singing that song too. Robin S is a different one.
Jody Watley,
MC Hammer, Shannon, move on. Oh, Shannon's let the music play. You won't get away. Somebody correct me now, motherfuckers.
Whoa, hey dude, hey, it's me.
If you were wrong, we would.
Here's Robin S, you cock smoker.
Oh, dude.
You gotta be strong. You gotta be
dude.
I love this song.
If you're looking for emotion. I'll do drugs.
Yo, I'm pushing this on some Rockford Fosgates. I got two 12-inch JBLs.
What I did is I went
pushing
and got
a 1400.
I just got a brand new GL distributor in the back for 218s.
I mean, you know Lewis's roommate, Jen? You could finger blast her for two straight hours of this music if you wanted to. I mean, this is her pocket. She texts me to go to... She's a comedian. Jenna...
Pistachio.
Pistachio, yeah. She's a comedian, and she's Lewis's roommate, and she... I get a text from her every 6 months being like, oh my God, can you believe MC Hammer, Shannon, and the Egyptian Lover are going to be... She goes, oh man, I went out. She's always blown away you can meet him. Do you know after a Slick Rick show, you can like meet him and hang? I'm like, of course you can. It's not 1982.
Do you know you can buy him a dinner before he gets back on a bus to another date? Oh, and then Right Said Fred's on this tour.
Who else is on?
I mean, I don't call
Who's
that
the rest
gay.
Of that list? Sugar Hill Gang.
Who's Chris? The Jets. What do the Jets do?
Oh, I remember the Jets.
Remember the Jets? Like the New York Jets?
No, are the Jets... You found out. I got a crush on you.
Yes.
Is it? Jets?
Yes.
It is, Jay. This is all blow music.
Well, I don't know about gay.
I didn't say gay.
Yeah, this is what you meant, though. You put blow in your butthole so it numbs it up for dicks.
Shut up, Marty.
You don't remember Crystal Waters? That's you gotta be strong. You gotta be fine. You gotta be fast.
It's like you're shoehorning it in. Oh. So George Lamont is alive. Oh, no, we were talking about Johnny O. So he's alive.
Johnny O is alive.
He's working.
He's alive.
Ooh, do you want to take, before we get into our conversation about our young, hot girls of the moment, Woe Vicky and Danielle Brajoli, Cash Me Outside, had some words. But before we get to that, we should take one more system call here because we got a young lady from Texas.
From Tejas.
Where we're going
this
weekend.
Moon Tower
Austin,
this Texas. Thursday through Saturday.
The whole gang's going. We got Jacob, DJ Lou, Black Lou, Christine, Dan, and myself. Coming to a motherfucking Antone's.
Yeah.
To do a live. I don't know if that's where Lindsay's from, but she says she has a system in her truck. And parentheses. Black Lou, you know, I read everything on the screen when you give it to me, says, sounds white girl hot.
Yeah, I mean, that's Lou's shit.
Who's going to argue that? Not so much for myself, but for Lou. I know you need a new pit crew partner because you lost your other one who threw her smock back at you.
I don't believe in your racing techniques. You never drop the hammer.
I feel like every argument you guys ever had, you were constantly wiping down with a rag a wrench of some sort.
Oh, or when he had to explain himself, he went like this. Well, he's leaned under the hood, and he gets up, and he goes, well, Lindsay, I don't know. He's wiping his hands off with the rag, and he goes, yeah, you could look at it like that. Or you could look at it like, also, first off, tighten that bottom one first. Okay. Anyways, yeah, I want to go out with you this weekend. I need a 5/8.
Yeah. He's lava soaping where he has the hands up with the, you know, the fucking, you had to grab that big glob of shitty soap at shops. God, I washed my hands with that so many times in my life. I've never worked in a shop, but I've always done stuff around the shop. My Uncle Tommy had a shop before. Just remember, like, being in, hanging out in shops for some reason. Lindsay in Texas, first of all, what sound you pumping out of that system so we can get you a better music?
I had, well, what I mainly listened to in high school was Slim Thug.
Jeez.
All right.
All right. Molly, and, you have a Slim Thug?
What age did your dad leave?
I'm scared. Oh, Jesus Christ.
So he left at 7?
Well, I went to, like, a predominantly black school, so, but I was the lone white girl who had a system in her truck, and the only way I can describe it is 90% white trash with 10% class.
Hang on a second. Now, sad. Lindsay, can I ask you a question? Hang on, sorry. Hang on. Black loose dick knocked my microphone away.
Sorry, it's growing so fast and rapid, it's pushing us all out of the studio.
Sorry, hang on. It's just getting a little tight in here. It's getting a little humid.
My face is against the window.
Lindsay, do me a favor. Fart in the phone. Fart in the phone.
Lindsay, just tell us you only date white dudes. It'll go down. It's getting bigger.
Oh,
this glass is breaking like a fucking shark aquarium.
It's learning.
It's adapting.
Godless, you were the one white girl in your school.
Well, there was a couple of us, but they'd always have competitions out in our high school parking lot.
Oh, my God. What kind of competitions, Lindsay? This is going to be a sad call. All right. Let's see which white girl gives head the best.
No, and so I competed my truck in, like, the all-black, like, systems competition, and I actually did fairly well, so I was very proud of my truck.
Everyone was confused that you were playing Glenn Campbell music. What's that song? The Something Georgia Line.
Are you just reciting a speech? Is this a political speech with bass?
What system did you have? What were your specs?
I had Kenwood. I had 212s in the back, and I had...
You had some thumbs.
And then I had Kenwood all around, and I had a nice deck. And I don't know all the specs because I'm a girl, obviously.
Yeah, Black Blue's got a nice deck.
Yeah, you could say it like that if you're in your rush.
I'll see Black Blue whenever he comes to Austin.
Well, I mean, that's this week.
Did you say I'll sleep with Black Lou whenever I come to Austin? There's no way she said that.
No, she said I'll see Black Lou.
Oh, I thought she said I'll sleep.
Yeah, and you go, I mean, we're there on Thursday.
Yeah, we're going to be there on Thursday.
I'll be there.
You better bring your sounds.
I'll bring my trashy truck so y'all can see it.
It was cool. If your sounds are dope enough, I'll let you finger me in it.
Can't wait.
Jay's balls are flopped.
I wanted to tell Dan something.
What'd you want to tell me?
You want him to finger you. I get it. He's the handsome one.
Stop it.
I had a sex dream about you the other night.
Yeah.
Wait, Black Lou got mad about that. Because you were.
Sorry, Black Lou.
There was a great sex dream. Black Lou was plowing me and you were watching.
Whoa. I'm no pink cook.
Listen, I feel bad for you, Lou, because the one thing that you cannot compete with is Black Dong.
It's true.
Every day, all
it's
day.
It's so true.
What was the sex dream, Lindsay?
He was just plowing me out, but it was amazing, and he had that deep voice, and it was perfect.
Well, what was another?
It's another sex dream with Dan.
Was I
another happy customer in a sex dream with Dan?
That's great. Cool.
I'm Dan.
What was I doing? Was I running the show with a guest host while Dan handles things elsewhere?
In the back. We were in the back.
Oh, really good. What was going on? Were me and Sherrod Small doing a show in the background, trying to hold together?
I go, Jay, I said billions had to plow out another fan.
What really got me wet was his strat ass that he had.
Yeah, the 96 strat ass? That shit was untinted.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's totally cool.
I just
cool.
had to tell you that, Dan. It was awesome.
Well, I'm glad I could satisfy you in your dreams while Jay held it down to the guest room.
Yeah. Where did he finish, Lindsay, in this perfect dream? Inside of you because you can't get pregnant in a stupid dream?
Well, guess what?
In a stupid-ass dream.
I'm your dream baby daddy.
And I finished inside. Blah, blah, blah.
And then I left, and I ain't going to pay dream child support.
Oh, yeah. If you fuck a girl who's bumping Slim Thug out of a truck, pull out early.
That woman is fertile.
Pull out early, man. Because she is a person who has a dream of having a pinball machine in her house one day, and no one wants that. Thank you so much for the call, Lindsay. That was hilarious.
Thank you. Y'all are the best.
We'll see you in Austin, yeah?
See you in Austin.
Can't wait.
Cool. You get to make your Dan Soder sex dreams a reality.
Not your sex dreams. You can bang Black Lou.
Oh, and you have to bang Black Lou. And everyone's going to get a little. How about something for White Lou and then also Jacob? What can they do, too? I mean, how big is this truck?
It's pretty big. It can fit a lot in the back.
Sick. Thanks for the call, Lindsay.
Thank you, guys.
Let's get to... Is that Fat Method Man?
Don't say that.
Is that Slim Thug?
Slim Thug.
That's hilarious. He's...
Not that
so is it an ironic name?
Yes.
Okay, I didn't get that.
Yes, same.
I don't know. Is he slim for a thug?
Dude, I heard someone give a Pete Wentz laugh in the office today as Jay and I were walking outside in a crowd. A guy really did laugh like that.
Because there's literally nobody more synonymous with dance than Pete Wentz.
Oh, fuck.
He's so confused.
God damn,
so
it rattles me every time I hear it. So a couple of people tweeted at us. Whenever certain shit happens in pop culture, people tweet at us things. Huey Lewis not being able to hear anymore, so he can't sing. Get better, Huey.
Especially when we were in ground level with all these things.
Yeah.
Huey Lewis, we were mentioning before anybody else was.
Yeah.
And I know what you're thinking. His career's been 30-some-odd years longer than the show.
Shut up.
But no one was paying attention.
Shut up.
Till Bonfire put him on the map.
Yeah.
And that's me hitting the thing on the microphone.
That's our dicks. That's our dick wagon that we were at.
That's our dicks. So
that's our dick shout out to the big dick of them all, Huey Lewis.
Ground level. Jimmy Buffett. No one's mentioning him.
Dude, we got to go see Margaritaville.
Bonfire. We don't have to.
No, we do.
There's no rule. There's no rule.
I think we need to see that play.
I'll go see it with you. I'll hold your hand.
We'll do those edibles. The ones that scared Mike.
Oh, yeah. Mike Vecchione just came out like a zombie. Fucking tidy whitey BVDs.
Dude, I started laughing. I gave him an edible last night. I told Jay this before we were talking about this. Like, I know we got 10 minutes. Vecchione and I did edibles last night. I don't know if he wants me to put this out there. Who cares?
Well, it wasn't eating like... Eat the edible, though. He crushed it up and snorted it because, you know, he's got an addiction problem. Go ahead. You were telling your story?
We ate edibles last night that I got from L.A.
Because I passed out. Vecchione got a hooker. He was involved in a lot of stuff. I think he agreed to carry some heroin over the border.
I'm pretty sure he robbed the Amalgamated Bank down on 21st Street. I think he broke in and took the safe.
Is there anybody in there?
No, but he took too much of an edible and he came out in the living room in his skivvies. And he goes, I think you gave me too much.
And you're like,
and I was like, what, dude? You all right? He's like, what should I do? And I was like, drink water.
What should I do? He goes, man, get to writing, dude.
Dude, this is when you sing your song.
Fear, happy, sweaty, sadness, goodness.
But anyways, we watched Family Guy and then he slept like a champ.
Hell yeah.
Speaking of pop culture,
one of our favorites... The Breege.
Got into it.
The Breege. Well, yes, you know, internet sensations. The girl who wanted everyone to cash her outside, yet somehow has figured out how in the limited time that I've even known who she was to go from white trash animal to
Dr. Phil
multi-millionaire.
Yeah, she's got more money than God.
Her, and of course we know of the other.
Vicky, here's the thing is... Danielle Brajoli, we've watched go from Dr. Phil to We Made the Japanese Metal when she screamed at the Dr. Phil producer, and then when her first songs came out. So we have a little more at stake with Danielle Brajoli. Whoa, Vicky, we found out was just, a rich girl from Georgia that was just basically doing this as a character to get internet fame and talking shit.
Well, I want to say real quick, before we do this, we should play this video. I saw something on the last page, Christine, you were on, in the recommended videos, something that said, Whoa, Vicky talks normal. And like a picture. I saw that too. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Click that. I want to see what that means. This is because this is a girl who talks very like, you know, everyone knows Whoa, Vicky from the show. Here we go.
Favorite black girl, Whoa Vicky, is back, and she is still up by three other guys. All right, and keep in mind, these guys.
I would, but like, this is just my voice, like, this is my accent. I don't even sound like.
All right, and Jesus Christ, finish.
So where does she talk normal?
Yeah, I don't.
You probably got to sit and watch that whole thing.
Or they just said it to get clicks on it. And it's just some...
Well, no, that seems like someone's definitely going to shit on her. So I'm pretty sure it's going to go that direction. But anyway, Whoa Vicky is known for, I don't know what, quite honestly. Being Whoa Vicky?
Yeah, just kind of doing that shit. Anyways, they're both garbage humps.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But
one of them's a millionaire.
One of them is a millionaire. One of them's... Well, listen, I'm not into what Danielle Bergioli does at all, but, like, they've put her on some thing where, I mean, I've sang Hi, Bitch almost every time I've answered, like, picked up or answered the phone for Christine since that song came out. Hi, Bitch. Hi, Bitch. Hi, Bitch. Hi, Bitch.
Hey, what video
something,
is this?
Something.
This is Hi, Bitch.
Dookie Balls.
Oh, wait. Spinning be your mama see. You know what? That's a remix.
Oh. Hanging with Bacob. Eating cake.
Eating cake. Hobbish.
Hobbish.
Hobbish. Video games. All white. Lineups. 2K. 18. Round ball.
Dude.
Classic. Hobbish.
Watching Jacob get little giggly shits when people were calling in and going, like, I was pushing 212s. I was had a Rockford Fudge. And Jacob was better giggling. Hobbish. 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 Oh, you hear that system right there?
Nope.
It's a 1200 amp. JBL, Dan, I don't know, you feel that thump right there? I paid extra for that. You see how it feels like the back of your eyes hurt?
So you're going to get that.
They put that in
here
there.
At Buck's studio, here at Buck's Stereo, gets a little umph into it. Yeah, it really gets you going, does it?
A high-bish. High-bish.
I really thought you being an actor would bring some pussy in here, and it does. And it does. And I got a nerve to ask why she all right. Anyways, I don't want to hear this fucking awfulness.
So, whoa, Vicky.
Ah, here it is. Simpler days.
Wow.
So she gets in there. I guess her and Whoa Vicky have had, we've talked about that before, there's some internet beef of just like, you know, when there's two idiots occupying the same space.
Yeah.
They're just going to...
Dum-dums.
Not like each other.
Real dum-dums.
So it's probably been a bunch of Instagram shit-talking that I would never be privy to. So if you will, I guess they encountered each other somewhere. Do they know where this happened? It was in L.A.?
At a mall? Looks like a mall.
Is that a P.F. Chang's? They
that
better
could
not.
Could be Beverly Center.
They better not. Is that my old P.F. Chang's, Christine, right
I
there?
Think so.
I'll fucking go ham right now.
Oh, dude, if they fucked with you getting a lettuce wrap as an appetizer.
A Mongolian beef, I'll spin kick somebody. Dan's drinking water. He's ready for this fight. So, we probably bring you Danielle, Bad Baby. Versus Whoa Vicky.
Fighting out of the left corner by way of New Jersey, Dr. Phil, she is 13 years old with a rack of a 28-year-old, Danielle Bad Bobby Bregioli.
She has to be 15 by now, right? Every time I mention her, I just get a year. She's probably 22 by now,
guys,
right?
Guys, what, she's 28?
It's fine, she's 29, right?
She's divorced.
That video's going to come out soon, right? Some porn video
Let's
of her?
Do this shit.
Oh, wow. It says, whoa, Vicky's 18.
Nah.
Oh, bitch, what?
Black Lou's like, hmm?
Why wouldn't say that? Does that excite you, Lou? You don't like black white girls who act like that, do you? I mean, she's a boof.
Not for long relationships, no.
Okay, there he is.
He's going to break her off a little bit and show what real black living's like?
Give her a piece of Wakanda, go back to the real world. Give her some of your vibranium.
You want to run somewhere?
Okay, this is it.
Oh, don't walk in front of
me. You want to run somewhere?
Let them talk. You can't do like that. Hey, put your shoes on.
Let me tell you right now. You can tell right now from the immediate jump that Whoa Vicky's from a rich family and Danielle Bergioli's from fucking
garbage.
The gutter.
Oh, yeah.
Because the way she's just walking up, slapping her gum like a cop, and she's like, you want to walk away? Huh, bitch? And Whoa Vicky's like, what's happening?
She's like, oh, yeah. And it gets better as the video goes on because Whoa Vicky has a whole bunch like that. I don't even know what's going on here.
But you can tell Whoa Vicky gets big whenever the security gets in between them. Let's hit play.
Touch stuff? Put your bag down, touch stuff?
Hey,
no,
well,
everything's right. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Just put her bag down.
Come on.
Hey,
what's up?
Hey,
do something.
Just stop. Ain't gonna do that like that.
Who is the tiny Asian girl that just pops up at the Bonfire SXM? We'll tweet out the video.
She's Lil Tay.
Who's Lil Tay?
Oh, that's the fuck. Isn't that the fucking
little Asian girl that?
Yeah, remember she's the idiot. It was like,
oh my god, how do they all hang out?
No,
together?
You remember that girl who cursed a bunch? Remember?
Baby, she a bitch. She's trying to act cool with her bodyguard, but she can't do shit. She can't even punch right, bitch. She a pussy. Broke ass bitch, you can't fight for shit.
She's
and you a bitch.
Who are these children?
Dude. Wait, hold on, go back.
Is that the cursing 9-year-old?
Yeah, hold on, go back. What about Vicky?
And my sister. Yeah, bitch. Go back to
my sister.
Yeah, bitch. Go back to beating up your mom on Dr. Phil.
Okay, I just want to say, yeah. I'll never let them beat each other up, you tiny cello playing cunt. I'm on Woe Vicky's. I'm against Woe Vicky. That's why I fucked your mom, you big tooth motherfucker.
What's the deal on little Tay's fucking background? Why is this little 9-year old able to do this?
I mean, how is her face not just being palmed and her being tossed to the side?
I mean, like, I still think, Catch Me Outside beats Woe Vicky
and
Lil Tay in a heartbeat.
I'll go handicap match all day.
I think Lil Tay goes, and you give her golf cleats, Lil Tay's out in one shot. That's a sidekick.
Yeah. She's just a tiny little thing. You can just fling her to the side. Lil Tay? All right, so Lil Tay pops up and starts talking shit with Woe Vicky.
You trying to fight?
Come on, touch me. I want you to hit me. Hit me, bitch. Stop. Hit me. If you hit me, I'll hit me.
I'm right here.
You coming at me, so you hit me.
Whoa, Vicky, those are some big old titties.
Dude.
Holy shit. Look at that outfit boating out. Dude, giving you some heavy cleavage.
That's what I was saying when I was like 18. I was like, all right, I saw part of this video where I felt a little bad. And I was like, Jesus.
I mean, you almost hope she gets knocked out. It's like, yeah. Is that pass out with just one fat tit like coming up to her neck? Like, just came out of the bra.
Yeah. Someone put that in. Little Tay, grab that titty.
Tay-Tay. Tay-Tay, do me a favor, wrangle them titties for me.
Hey, short round. Grab her. Tit?
Yo, dog, this little Tay-Tay, she my titty wrangler.
I'm her short round to Dr. Jones.
That should be her first song.
Dr. Jones.
If her first song isn't called Dr. Jones.
I don't know how we're possibly going to get through this video. 4 minutes left to go. God,
we're only 33 seconds in.
Okay, give it a shot.
You coming at me, so you hit me.
It's about it back?
Play Master P, about it. Is that back now?
Bada, rowdy. Oh,
is No Limit? Is the No Limit rain about to restart?
I mean, I honestly got to think this might be porn for Black Lou.
Oh, watching
big-titted white women argue and talk black shit. You know, both these girls are dying for black dick. Like, that is for God.
Jesus, what was that?
Sorry.
I started this body by
Yeah.
Get them up.
His best friend is a black guy.
They say you body. Yeah, they label me a drug dealer. Cause I'm wild. I'm wild.
Bad. What are you pushing? I got Clarion faceplate.
I got a JBL 15, and that's linked up through two side splits.
I got a couple of my friend Glenn sent me his.
I worked at Car Toys for 6 years. I didn't. There was just one by my mom's house. They got turned into a McDonald's because no one cares about systems anymore.
That's so funny. JL Audio Subwoofs.
Let's come back for the rest of this video tomorrow. Was that a tease? I mean, our show's over.
I know.
I gotta go to New Jokes.
That was a tease because I'm sorry, everybody.
Oh, and who can love?
And don't worry, everyone. That's not what you think. We had the blur on our face. Dude, that's not Black Lou with a black woman.
Dude, I love that someone tweeted back. What's the name?
Tars. It's our artist for our Moon Tower poster.
She tweeted back, and who can love you like me?
Nobody.
Who can sex you like me?
Nobody.
And who can lay your body down? Nobody, baby.
Nobody.
And the band keeps playing on. I mean, perfect. He has Black Lou has Keith Sweatface in that.
No shit. He really, and I like the head down too. Like, what's up? This is me and my baby boo getting ready to fuck it out on this shark car.
Oh, what you looking right here is my Zinfandel. This is my white Zinfandel.
She's a dessert wine to be tasted, not pounded.
I will be back tomorrow on the Bonfire Live.
We'll get into this Brigioli story tomorrow.
What's at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter. You know, follow us and then go to bigjcomedy.com, dansoder.com.
All
that shit.
Watch Billions. Do stuff.
Do stuff.
Think about it.
Go, I think Sixers.
I think my special is, I think my hour's on In Demand right now.
Hell yeah, so is mine.
On Comedy Central. Oh yeah, both?
No very, one watched our, very yeah. Nice. So if you want to go see our hour specials, go on Comedy Central right. On Demand.
They are Comedy Central On Demand right now. Go Sixers.
Go
one,
Sixers.
Two, three, four, five, Sixers.
The Sixers.
Everybody, 10, 9, 8, 76ers.
And the Nuggets.
Go team. Mwah. Ciao, baby.
Ciao.